Okay, so now in the previous class we were talking about the series representation of complex numbers. So we looked at the Taylor series, which follows from the expression, it follows from the Taylor series expansion for real functions. And then I did not do this part, convergence of Taylor series. So I said I'll do it a little later. First I wanted to give you to just you all to just try out. Okay, so I just wanted you all to find out the Taylor series expansion for these. Okay, so which I had left to you all for as your assignment, as your homework. So I hope you have done this. Now I'll go back to this convergence of the Taylor series. Okay, the convergence of the Taylor series. You see, any series representation, whenever we say series representation, it is an infinite series. That means there are infinite number of terms. Okay, but if there are infinite number of terms, then there is a possibility that this series, when you add them up, this series is going to go towards infinity. Because there are infinite number of terms, the series itself may go towards infinity. Okay, so in that case, we are interested in the series which converges. That means as the number of terms, as it goes towards infinity, the series itself does not go towards infinity. The series, it converges to some particular point. Okay, so that's what we meant by convergence of a Taylor series. So a series representation, we say that a series, because we are talking about a complex series, okay, so we are interested in a convergence within a disk. Okay, we are interested in convergence, whether the series converges or not within a disk. Okay, z minus z naught less than r, you, if you recall from the previous lectures. So suppose I have, let's say, a complex plane. Okay, this is the real axis and this is the imaginary axis. What is z minus z naught equals r? Z minus z naught equals r. If you recall, this is nothing but a circle, right? This is a circle whose center, the center of the circle is z naught, and the radius of the circle is r. So let's say this is z naught. Okay, this is z naught. So when I say z minus z naught equal to r, we are talking about this circle. Okay, so this is a circle whose center is a z naught and whose radius, this radius is r. Okay, now instead of equal to, okay, so we had z minus z naught. So z minus z naught equals r, it's a collection of all these points which lie on the circumference of this circle. Z minus z naught equals r means all the points which lie on the circumference of this circle. Now if I say z minus z naught is less than r, what does that imply? Z minus z naught less than r, it is a collection of all the points which lie inside the circle. Okay, so when I say z minus z naught is less than r, all the points which lie inside this circle in the shaded region, those points, we refer to those points as z minus z naught less than r. So that's why this is known as a disk. This was known as a disk. All the points inclusive. Okay, all the points inside the circle inclusive. That makes it a disk. Okay, so here r is known as the radius of convergence. Okay, r is known as the radius of convergence. And this radius of convergence is the distance of the nearest singularity from z naught. What is singularity? The point where the function becomes undefined. Okay, where the function blows up or becomes undefined. Okay, so that's a singularity. Okay, so the radius of convergence r is defined as the distance of the nearest singularity from z naught. Okay, so let's say I'm having many different points. Okay, let's say I am having many different singularities. So this is one singularity, this is another singularity, this is one more singularity, right? Okay, so we need to find out what is the minimum distance. Okay, what is the minimum distance from z naught to, okay, any of these points? That minimum distance becomes the radius of convergence. So here zi represents all the singularities of f of z. Okay. So an illustration of this is given over here. Okay. So if f of z is not analytic at z naught, then there is no valid power series representation, which as we all already know, because I had already explained to you what is the meaning of analyticity physically, what does this mean? I mean, not physically. How do we understand? Okay, how do we interpret the analyticity of a function? I had already expressed to you. If a function is analytic, then it has got a power series representation. If it does not have a power series representation, then it is not analytic. Okay. So now, this definition that I had explained here, that R is the minimum of Zi minus Z naught. Okay. So R is the minimum. R, the radius of convergence that we are talking about, it is the minimum of Zi minus Z naught, the minimum distance between the singularity and the point Z naught that we are talking about. So this is understood in this way. So suppose I have this point Z naught over here. Okay, so Z naught is this point. This is the point Z naught. Okay. And then this Z1, Z2 and Z3, these are the singularities. This is one singularity, this is another singularity, this is one more singularity. So we consider three singularities. Now I want to find out singularities of what? Singularities of this function. Okay. Z1, Z2, Z3, these are singularities of a function. That means this function f of z, it becomes undefined. Okay, it becomes undefined at these three points. So an example could be, okay, an example of this, this could be of such a function. So for instance, let's say if I say f of z equals to z divided by z minus z1, okay, z minus z2 and z minus z3. Okay, so if f of z is equal to this quantity, then if you put z equals z1, we'll get a zero in the denominator. Z equals z2, you'll get a zero in the denominator. Z equals z3 also, you'll get a zero in the denominator. So in all the three cases, you'll get zero in the denominator and the function becomes undefined. So z1, z2 and z3, all three of them, they are singularities. Okay, so this is an example, okay, of a function which is undefined, which has got singularities at three different points. So now suppose I have a situation like this. A function f of z has got singularities z1, z2 and z3, and there is a point z0 here which I consider over here, and the function f is analytic at this point z0. Then what we do is, from this z0 we find out what are the distances. So from this z0 you find out what is this distance, find out what is this distance, and find out what is this distance. So we can easily find out what are the values of these distances. This distance from z0 to z1, okay, that is this distance from z0 to z1, we can find out simply by taking the modulus z0, that is, or z1 minus z0 or z0 minus z1, anything you can take, because we are anyway going to take the modulus. So this distance is given by this. Similarly, I want to find out this distance, okay, the distance between z0 and z2, that is, this distance is what we want to find out. So this will be simply z2 minus z0. And finally, this distance, this will be z3 minus z0. So all you have to do is just take the difference between these two numbers and take the modulus. That is going to give us the distance between these two points. So we find out these three distances. Okay. Once you have found out these three distances, okay. So once you have found out these three distances, then figure out which is the smallest of these distances. One way by which you can find smallest is from here. You just keep on drawing circles. Okay. There are many ways. One way is you can just directly, you can calculate the distances, whichever is minimum, you can do that. Another way is from this Z naught, you draw a circle. Okay. Then you draw a bigger circle, increase the radius of the circle. Then you increase the radius of the circle some more. Okay. Then you increase the radius of the circle some more. You can keep on doing that. Keep on increasing the radius of the circle. Then a time is going to come, okay, when this circle is going to touch one of these points. Okay, a time is going to come when the circle is going to touch one of these points. Whichever point the circle touches first, okay, so that distance you measure, that will be the shortest distance. Okay, so this is the minimum distance between Z0 and any one of the singularities. So we choose a singularity that is nearest to Z0. And once we have done that, okay, we choose this singularity, because in this case, Z2, this is a point in which is closest to Z0. Okay, so we have found a singularity which is closest to Z0. And once we have found that, then we define this as R. This R is the radius of convergence. Okay, so R cannot be equal to this distance, it cannot be equal to this, it has to be equal to this, because this is a singularity which is closest. So find, whenever you have multiple number of singularities, find out the distances of each of these singularity from Z0, find out which distance is minimum, whichever distance is minimum, that distance is known as the radius of convergence of the Taylor series expansion for this function f of z. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what does that imply? It implies that all the points, like I said, f of z is analytic everywhere except at z1, z2 and z3, right? F of z is analytic everywhere except at z1, z2 and z3. Now if I consider this shaded region, is there any singularity within this shaded region? There is no singularity. That means within this shaded region, fz is guaranteed to be analytic. Okay, f of z is guaranteed to be singular, to be analytic, and hence it converges. It converges to some finite value. Hence, it converges to a finite value within this region, within this shaded region. And each and every point within this shaded region, the function f of z is analytic and it converges to a finite value. I cannot take this circle. If I take this circle, this as the radius of convergence, that is not possible, because if I take this as the radius of convergence, there is at least one point, that point is z2. There is at least one point which lies inside this circle, inside this disk, where the function is not analytic. So the function does not converge at this point. So moment I choose the minimum distance to be the radius of convergence, then it is guaranteed that the function is convergent at each and every point within this region. So we say that the function is convergent over here. Okay, the function converges here, and there is a Taylor series converges here, and hence this distance is known as the radius of convergence. This distance is known as the radius of convergence. Is this clear? Now you tell me, what do we want? Do we want the radius of convergence to be as large as possible or as small as possible?
No.
We want the radius of convergence to be as large as possible. Okay, we want the radius of convergence to be as large as possible. What will happen if radius of convergence is zero? What does it mean? Radius of convergence is zero. It means f of z is analytic. F of z is analytic only at a single point. And which is that single point? The single point is z0. If radius of convergence of a function, of a Taylor series expansion, if the radius of convergence happens to be zero, it means the function is analytic only, because radius of convergence is zero means this circle will become a single point. Which is the point? The point is z0. So if a radius of convergence is zero, that means the function is analytic only at one point. We are not really interested in this case because this is a trivial case. Okay, we are not really interested in this one. We are not really interested in functions which is analytic at only one point, right? Because if a function is analytic only at one point, then that function is of no use to us, right? We want to analyze the function. That means we want to give that function some room to move around. So for that, we need to have some kind of a region over which it is analytic. What will happen if R is infinity? If the radius of convergence, if it is infinity, what does this mean? Radius of convergence is infinity. That means this R goes towards infinity. That means this disk
this circular disk that we have, that circular disk is going to span all the way to infinity. That means this function is analytic over which points? It is analytic everywhere. So this is what we are interested in. We are interested in functions in which we want, we would love the function, actually not, need not always be the case, but we would love the function to be having a radius of convergence of infinity, because that means the function is analytic everywhere. Okay, is that clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is what we show over here. We said that the series represents. So this shaded region, the function is a Taylor series expansion of the function. It is convergent. The series is convergent within this shaded region. So we say that the series representation of the function about z naught is convergent inside a disk of radius r and centered about z naught. So this is what is meant by convergence of a Taylor series. Okay. Next, how do you find out the radius of convergence? There are two formulas. One is known as the ratio test, by using what is known as the ratio test. So all you need to do is this coefficients. You need to find out how these coefficients look like. What are the general, if you can find a general form of the coefficients, then what you do is you take the nth coefficient and you take the next coefficient. Any coefficient you take, any one coefficient you take, and then you take the next coefficient, an and an plus 1. You take the next coefficient and you just take the ratio between the two. And this ratio, you take the modulus and then you make n tends towards infinity. Find out what is the, what is this limit. Okay, whatever is this limit, that is going to be the radius of convergence. This is from the ratio test, which is generally the most common formula that we use. Another one is known as the nth root test. In the nth root test, what you do is you take an, okay, any of the coefficients, and then you take the modulus of this an and you take the nth root of this. 1 by raised to the power 1 by n means you're taking the nth root. That nth root of the modulus of this coefficient an, you take the limit as n tends towards infinity, and whatever is this limit, you take the reciprocal of that. That is going to give us the radius of convergence of this particular this is going to give us the radius of convergence for this particular series. So that is known as the nth root test. Okay. As an example, let's do these. Okay. We need to find out the radius of convergence for the following series. Let's do a few of these so that it becomes clear to you. So maybe I could do the first one and the third one maybe, and you can try the remaining two. Let me just grab these. Okay, so this is what we have. Okay, so this is the series summation z to the power n by n. Okay, so now let's just write this in a form which is of which is convenient to us. So we'll write this as summation n equals 1 to infinity, then 1 by n, right, 1 by n z to the power n. And if you remember the Taylor series expansion, what is the general form of the Taylor series expansion? N equals 1 to infinity, or z, actually speaking, n equals 0 to infinity, a n z minus z naught to the power n, a n z minus z naught to the power n. If you compare these two, okay, if you compare these two, so comparing we find, comparing we find, first of all, this series, it starts from here, it starts from n equals 0, here it starts from n equals 1. So that means the a 0 coefficient, that must be 0, right? Because here it's, because since the series starts from n equals 1. So because the series starts from n equals 1, that means a0 coefficient, a0, n equals 0, a0 coefficient is 0. Next thing that we see is this an. First, again,
z naught. Let's identify z naught. Which is z naught here? Here we have z to the power n. This can be written as, see, z to the power n can be written as z minus 0 to the power n, right? So z naught must be equal to 0. If you compare this, z naught must be equal to 0. Okay. Since z to the power n can be written as z minus 0 whole to the power n. Next thing that we notice here is this quantity inside the bracket, this must be equal to an. An, this quantity inside the bracket, it must be equal to the quantity inside the bracket, which is 1 by n. So an is equal to 1 by n. Is that clear, everyone? So we can now use the ratio test. Okay, we can now use the ratio test. What does the ratio test say? The ratio test says that the radius of convergence, it is equal to the limit as n tends towards infinity of the modulus of an divided by an divided by a n plus 1. This is what the ratio test says. Okay, so here first we find out this ratio, a n divided by a n plus 1. What will this be equal to? A n is in the numerator, a n is 1 by n, and in the denominator we have a n plus 1. All you have to do is n you replace with n plus 1. So 1 divided by, here n will get replaced with n plus 1. Okay, so this gives us 1 by n, because this is reciprocal, so it just goes up. So we have in the numerator we have n plus 1, and here we have divided by n. So this can be written as n by n is 1 plus 1 by n. So now it is very easy, because all you have to do is just take the limit. So therefore, the radius of convergence is equal to the limit as n tends towards infinity of 1 plus 1 by n. We don't have to really worry about this modulus, because n is positive, because it's, as you saw here, n takes the values from 1 to infinity. So n is always positive, and there is a plus sign here. So no need to worry about this. So you just take the limit as n tends towards infinity of 1 plus 1 by n. Now this is easy. All you need to do is just put this, put infinity over here. So 1 by infinity, this is going to give us 0. So what will be the result? The result will be 1. So this gives us the radius of convergence is equal to 1. Okay, so what is the radius of convergence of this series? The radius of convergence is 1. So how do we write this? Formally, how do we write this? We can write it like this. So therefore, we can say the series that is summation n equals 1 to infinity z to the power n by n. This was the series. Right? This is z to the power n by n. The series is convergent. The series is convergent over the disk, over this disk, that is z minus z naught. Z minus z naught is, z naught is 0 anyway, less than r, and r is 1. Okay, or for all values such that modulus of z is less than 1. So this series is convergent for all z modulus z less than 1. Is that clear,
everyone? Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, good. Next problem. Which one do you want me to do? 2, 3, 4, which one? Two, three, or four? You choose which one. Anyone? Let's let me do three, okay? If you're not choosing, I'll choose. Let me choose three. Okay. Two and four, I'll leave it to you for you to try at home. Okay, here also same thing, same as before. We'll just write this down in the standard form of a Taylor series. So this is equal to, this is equal to summation n equals 1, n equals 1 to infinity, n factorial divided by n to the power n, z to the power n. Okay. Oh, sorry. I've written the whole thing all over again. N factorial divided by n to the power n into z minus 0, because z minus 0 whole to the power n. And this is equal to n equals 0 to infinity a n z minus z naught whole to the power n. Okay. So here comparing, we get, first of all, as before, here the series starts from 0, here it starts from 1, that means a0 must be 0. Next thing that we note is z0 is also equal to 0, right? Z0 is also equal to 0. And lastly, we have an, we have an expression for an. An is n factorial divided by n to the power n. Okay, so now we need to find out the this radius of convergence of this one. So how do we go about doing that? Again, we can use the ratio test. Okay, so from ratio test, we have radius of convergence is equal to limit as n tends towards infinity of the modulus of the ratio of n a n divided by a n plus 1. Okay, so now next thing that we do is we find out this ratio. Okay, so therefore here a n divided by a n divided by a n plus 1, what is this equal to? So this is n factorial divided by n to the power n, and then divided by, I'll just write it as a reciprocal, so I'll put n to the power n. In a denominator we have n to the power n, so I'll just put as n plus 1, because n has to be replaced with n plus 1. So n plus 1 to the power, again there is a n that will get replaced with n plus 1, the whole thing divided by n plus 1 factorial. Okay, so now how do we go about solving this? Let's see. All right, now one thing that we know is this, right? If we recall, n factorial, that is n plus 1 factorial can be written as n plus 1 into n factorial. We can do that, right? So let's go ahead and do this. So we have So here, this will be, it will be n plus 1 into n factorial. Okay. Now some of these things will get cancelled out, right? Some of these things will get cancelled out. What will get cancelled out? What are the things that will get cancelled out? First of all, n factorial will get cancelled out. Next, there is a n plus 1, and here it is n plus 1 to the power n plus 1, right? n plus 1 can be written as n plus 1 to the power n into n plus 1, because to the power 1 is there, right? That means this n plus 1, this n plus 1 will cancel out this 1 here, okay? So as a result, what we have now left, what we have is n plus 1. What we have next is n plus 1 to the power n divided by n. We'll just take the power outside, whole to the power n. Is that clear? So this will be equal to, just write 1 plus 1 by n. Whole to the power n. Is that fine? So therefore, the radius of convergence will be simply the limit as n tends towards infinity, the limit of 1 plus 1 by n whole to the power n. And do you know what this result is? Anybody? Do you know what this result is? When you take this limit,
E, sir.
Yes. This result is E. Okay. And the value of E is, of course, 2.718. So this is the radius of convergence. So therefore, we can say here, hence, we say that this summation n equals 1 to infinity n factorial divided by n to the power n. Okay, this, it converges over the disk. That is z minus z naught. Z naught is 0. So z less than r. And what is r? R is e. So it converges over this disk. Okay. So this is how we can find out the radius of convergence of any particular series. Fine. Is this clear to everyone? Okay. I happen to find a new student here. Deepak. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Deepak, can you, when did you join?
Just now, sir.
No, I mean, when did you join join the MSc Physics course?
Let me check, sir.